Javier Milei, aka El Loco, the madman, El Peluca, the wig, or General Ancap, the cosplay alter ego, depending on who's asking.
This is a huge roll of the dice by Argentine voters, and not just by a few Argentine voters. This candidate won by 11 percentage points.
The former professor of economics and self-proclaimed sexpert had a rapid rise to political prominence, bursting into the Argentine National Congress only 2 years ago. Argentina's answer to Donald Trump launching his run for president on a radical lineup of policies, loosening gun laws, abolishing abortion, and even allowing the sale and purchase of human organs. His peculiar platform is perhaps unsurprising given his political advisors have four legs. He's cloned English mastiffs, each with their own portfolio. Milei's victory comes during turbulent economic times for Argentina. Annual inflation has risen to 143%, while 40% of Argentines live in poverty.
The easy reading of the election is that Argentines have become much more conservative and really embraced this far-right libertarian agenda. I think the reality is they are very unhappy with the status quo, very displeased with their traditional political parties, and ready to try something radically different.
It doesn't hurt that his presidential opponent was the Minister for Economics.
This is our chance to think long term, because maybe with this government there is hope.
So what's the general mad wig cap proposing? He plans to slash the size and role of the government and fix the economy by ditching the peso for the US dollar. Wildest of all, he wants to blow up the central bank, like literally kaboom, in order to prevent it from printing more money.
His economic ideas are fascinating. I think he correctly diagnoses Argentina's chronic problems. It spends too much money, and when it can't borrow internationally, it just prints pesos and causes very high inflation.
The new president facing an uphill battle to get his policies over the line.
He only has a handful of deputies in the Chamber of Deputies and about seven senators in the 72-seat Senate. So his ability to implement such radical changes is going to confront his limited political ballast, if you will.
So what happens when he can't do what the people voted for?
It's pretty wild stuff. I feel like I've been following this quite closely. My partner's Argentinian. I don't understand economics either. I think printing money sounds great. I'm like, more money, that should be how it works. Yeah. But hearing her family who are in Buenos Aires talk about this, there's kind of a lot of despair. They don't know what to do. They were kind of left with no choice. Like the former Minister for Economics, who kind of is kind of responsible for getting into this position of 140% inflation, which we're kind of stewing over, you know, 5 or 6% inflation here. It's hard to comprehend. All this kind of madman, they were kind of left with no real choice and kind of...
Isn't that weird that then to want change and to want something different because you are so disillusioned and then the only choice is that?
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of hard to even comprehend, right? Especially for a country that was so economically powerful at one point and through, you know, years and years and years of economic mismanagement has ended up in this position. And there are proud people as well. So it'll be interesting to kind of see what happened. Argentinians, they do protest. And so I don't... he's going to struggle to do a lot of things anyway with how it's set up politically. But it's going to be fascinating to watch.
I can imagine.